it's 51 degrees as number 7 Penn State challenges number 1 Ohio State. 51 degrees. It's been raining since somewhere early in the morning hours, and the forecast is for showers through the day with occasional gusty winds. Not terribly comfortable. It's clement, let's say. Not yet inclement. Penn State will kick off. They won the toss. They defer to the second half. Ohio State then will have the ball first with Kenyon Rambo and Jonathan Wells. Travis Forney will kick it off for the white-clad Nittany Lions, and the game is on. From the 7-yard line, Rambo. Out across the 25 to the 27. And they've got prime weapons Miller and Boston to the outside for the first snap. And Jermaine hands it away to Wiley. Wiley finds daylight on the left side of the line. He got a good block over there, and he moves the ball. Brandon Short and LeVar Harrington make the tackle for the Lions. The Penn State defense is by far the best group the Buckeyes will have seen so far this season. There are no timid souls in that group. Number 43, Brandon Short, is the leader of the linebacking core. You might want to keep an eye on number 11, Harrington. He's becoming quite a player. And the defensive backs, we've indicated, they're a smallest group. The corners, King and Macklin, are 5'8 and 5'9. The free safety, Lee, is 5'7. And they'll be rotating new, bigger people in there today. The ball is given to Matt Keller, the fullback. And Matt Keller. And he is
in there with Boston and Miller.
And they go the other way with it, with Keller carrying. And this time the Lions searching out and find him for a yard or so loss on the play. Anthony King coming up from a corner, got it. Jermaine back. Fakes the pass, fakes the reverse, wants to let it go. Lions won't give him a chance. Good defensive coverage. Downfield, Boston had no shot and long.
You called it right, Hoss. It takes a while to develop the reverse, and that allowed Boston to get downfield. There's only one receiver. Watch as he's going to be double covered. Good coverage by Fox, number 4, coming back. Boston, number 9.
What to do with Boston through much of the day, and that's doubling.
Oh, you got that right.
I would, too. Jermaine's pass to the sidelines is incomplete. Germany's over there. Germany got himself involved with the Penn State defender, so involved as a matter of on the return. And Chile's starting lineup now for Penn State. On the left side of the line, Wedderburn and McKenzie are two houses. They're big. The rest of them up front are also over 300 pounds, except for Fagan. Joe Nastasi is the steady guy. Corey Jones has been sharing that wideout position with Choppy Fields. The backs, Nittany Lions, do not have that big old thumping tailback right now. Cordell Mitchell, however, is a slashing runner and has done quite well. And Mitchell has the ball, and he's trucked for a long. Second down and 15 for the Nittany Lions. And the quarterback gets it in the air. The pass is Corey Jones. And so Kevin, California Speedsters. No pressure. The kick is away. It's a good kick. Rambo with Ruth. Got by the first one, but the second one hit him right on the numbers.
He sure did.
Over and sets him up with Wiley deep and drops back to throw on first down. To the sidelines to Boston. The pass is incomplete, off his hands, out of bounds. David Macklin. Jermaine wants to go big with it. He goes down to Miller. Miller is in a struggling match of that pass interference. He gets the call on Anthony King. King had him locked up about
this. This is a new wrinkle the Buckeyes have not shown so far this season.
Here comes the blitz. And it's Keller with the ball, trying to sweep it. And it's Macklin who buggers up the play. And
three wideouts are in the shotgun. And Jermaine back on third down, lets it go into the middle. The pass is caught by Miller. The ball was thrown behind the steady.
Jermaine drops the ball, has to cover it. Number 5, Brad Scioli. Coming around, looped past
the end, and that may be an odd thing you say. Scioli was a quarterback in high school, and when he came to Penn State, he was still a quarterback, so he got the number 5, and he grew out of the position.
And it's Boston, the man in motion. Jermaine back, pressure coming, dumps it off. Ball goes to Wiley. Wiley trying to get outside. Can't do it. Short trying to pop through, can't do it. Jermaine steps away from the pressure. Now he needs a little help. He's got the first down.
That's the wild card.
Right? So like drizzle, partner?
It depends on what part of the country you come from. Michael White, you're sitting in front of the fire. Yeah. Hey. Down to the 21-yard line.
I figured most of everybody knew it.
Harrington almost got caught. They get Wiley behind the line of scrimmage. It's Brandon Short, number 43.
First quarter. Stokes first down, just short of their own 23-yard line. Hand the ball off to Cordell Mitchell, who bounces outside, and there's nobody there for a long time until finally Ahmed Plummer disentangles himself from a would-be
block. But watch the block of Ceramelli right here. And the other outside defensive back, Barry's going to run himself out of the play. Ceramelli gets a nice block, and Barry just comes in too wide.
Eric McCoo in the backfield now on first down for the Nittany Lions, and they're on the Ohio State side for the first time today. The ball is thrown to the outside for McCoo. Thompson back. Little play action to free it up. The ball tipped in the air. Caught by Shoppy Fields.
Catch. Top route. He cut in front of him. Plummer just couldn't get up high enough to pick it off. And Shoffy just stays with the football and makes a play where the wide receivers have been troubling.
Second down and 12 for Penn State. Oh, that's a pretty good play right there. But Cordell Mitchell is back in the backfield. Kevin Thompson passes away to the sidelines. And how do you do? Penalty flags again. That ball is kicked into the end zone. Let's see about this flag. Here comes Wiley. Pretty good coverage. Coming across. Well, the Nitties are having a good go. Out of the shotgun, Jermaine has time. His pass is away. His man is wide open. David Boston. First down, Buckeye. It's been available. Back to Wiley. Trying to run in behind. Got him a warm reception, too. Third down and 6. Jermaine's pass is away. Down the middle. It is Dean Miller. Jermaine hands it to Wiley. And ball from the outside is fumbly. And he took him right down. And they're going to deny fumble. Scioli came in there like a rocket.
Yep.
Yeah, you're right. It is. Ball came out. Third down and 10. Wiley's up for him. Got him in behind the line of scrimmage.
Oh, boy.
Scioli again.
Scioli say hello there.
And it continues the light rain. Oh, that's a high snap. And they block it. And it's picked up by the Nittany Lions. King has it, and they throw him out of bounds up around the 47-yard line.
They give you the punter. Yeah, it was a high snap. Threw off the timing of the kicker and just enough time to allow Macklin. Joe said last night, we need some breaks in the kick to get there as a snap is high. Normally, he wouldn't have time to get there, but with a high snap, Stoltz hesitated.
1 yard run that won that game for him over there last year. And Thompson's pass is away down the middle. It is incomplete, intended for Nastassi. Handed off to Cordell Mitchell. And Niall Dick, pay-per-view. See what they've got. Back goes Thompson to throw. The pass is caught this time. Right on the money by Joe Nastassi.
Thompson now 5 of 6 throwing the football. On a wet day, good protection. And a nice throw. Winfield off of him, takes the bite to the inside.
And good move by Joe. He's very steady. He's their possession receiver. He's the senior. First down for Penn State. First real threat of the ball game. It's Mitchell. Thompson's pass quickly to the sideline. Caught by Corey Jones, and Jones is making it a 42-yard field goal try for the lead. And he got it. And a penalty flag. Hold it. Hold it.
Running defense and special teams.
The kick is to the 1 yard line for Jonathan Wells. Bend him over backwards and take him down.
Penn State is slowing him down today.
Jermaine back. Case. Now he's got room. He's got to have the first down. The pursuit is from LeVar Arrington. He reached in there and punched the ball out of it.
Talked about being the running back in high school. He's coming on the blitz. He's been held there. He said, the heck with the tackle. I want to make a turnover here.
Even Joe Jermaine was laughing about
it
when he went back to the huddle.
Yeah, he was.
Well, the Penn State defense is working very well. Now they got Wiley going outside again. Back to the throw and catch stuff. And that ball is thrown way back behind. Joe Montgomery is back in the backfield. He's got the ball. And in traffic. got a return on, trying to give Rambo a little room. Put two guys on those speed streak now. One of them got loose. Rambo's looking at him. Now he's going to outrun him. Get around the corner. Scary Adams.
Look out, some room.
And he's out of bounds to stop the clock up at midfield. For this snap, Joe Germain rolling out, trying to buy a little time. Steele is after him. The pass is away. The man's there down on the 35-yard line.
A minute and a half to go.
Germain back. Protection's good. Pass is complete. D. Miller. Miller still going. Still going. Oh, he's something. Down to the 33.
Just keeps going.
Second and eight.
Germain's pass is slapped down at the line of scrimmage. Underneath. Oh my goodness, that's almost intercepted by Fleischer. Bullet.
Defensive backs and made the play.
And on first down, Germain goes down the middle for the tight end, and he didn't hold it. Incomplete.
It's second down and 10 with 35 seconds to play.
Handed off to Keller. And Keller, the fullback, lunges to the sidelines at the 20-yard line, stopping the clock at 28. Miller's back out there. Germain looks down the middle, goes to Wiley. Touchdown.
Like you said, that drive took forever.
They'll run it with Mitchell coming up the middle, and they apparently are willing to go to the clubhouse. They're going to put that ball up and give the Buckeyes a chance to handle it that close to their goal line. And once the chains are put down, the clock will go again with 12 seconds. So they'll have one more.
Joe's ready to take it to the house.
Yep, he's ready to go in and have a little visit.
Have a little chicken soup, a little broth, and warm up and talk about it.
Well, I thought Penn State held up very well. Ohio State did get one late to lead.
Number one are the deep people for Penn State.
Schultz gets a good one. It's 2-3 yards into the end zone for Branch, who's coming out. Mistake.
Now a look at the Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, first half stats.
The turnover by Penn State, we just showed you, led to 7 points by Ohio State. Look at the numbers for Penn State. Not much there if you're an offensive-minded person. If you like defense, it's pretty good defense for Ohio State.
500
yards per game.
Kevin Thompson back to throw it, swings it out to Mitchell, and Mitchell is swept down. Moore creeping in. Damon Moore on a blitz coming in when he didn't really.
The end zone. Pat Pigeon back there and Kenyon Rambo waiting for Ohio State.
Buckeyes ought to come out of here with pretty good. They block it. Ball's in the end zone. Touchdown, Ohio State. Percy King blocked the kick.
Cordell Mitchell is behind him as the deep back. Uncle Brown is in motion. Give it to Mitchell. Gets away from 1-2. And nice run by Cordell Mitchell before he's finally pushed out. Stay with the run. Up to the 45.
Second down and 7.
And the pass completed to Shoppy Fields down on his knees.
Here comes Moore. Passes away and it is incomplete.
Move back now on the shift for the tight end to the other side and give it inside to Michael Wiley. And there's nothing there.
Here's one.
Forcing Ohio State to go somewhere else.
There's one down the middle. And
it is intercepted by David Macklin. Nice play, David.
Yes, very nice.
Intended for David Boston. Running him back into the middle, and Macklin played it as well as you can play it.
It's a slant pattern to Boston. Germain throws it out in front, and Macklin has enough speed to undercut him. You don't do that very often, because if you undercut and the ball gets there, he is up.
Kevin Thompson going big. Nastasi got it. Down 1 yard line. Not a touchdown.
Big interceptions over his career. He's one of those defensive backs that stays with you. You don't catch many balls, but he doesn't intercept many. That looks like a touchdown.
Saramelli. There's a touchdown.
So Mike Ceramelli takes it and muscles it into the end zone for the touchdown. And the Nittany Lions answer.
Going for two, Bob.
Are they?
Mm-hmm.
All right. But an interception, one play later, or two plays later.
They'll stack them up and then shift them out. And it's a pass play, folks. Throwing, no. Intended for Nastasi, had no chance to get it. Yep, that's what pressure on the quarterback will do. Can't complete passes flat of your back. Scioli and Brown. Boom, boom. Ball turned into a knuckleball.
That ball was almost intercepted.
Pretty close.
Courtney Brown, 81, hits Jermaine and more.
Passes away, and they complete it again, and they get a first down out of it. And John Lumpkin finally got one thrown where he could catch it.
He's out of the
corner. This is Wiley trying to get loose. LeVar Arrington kept him from that. Had Michael
number 11. Moves around, inside, outside. This time he comes around. Not many defensive players could make that play coming from the outside.
In there as a tight end. Jermaine is second. Scioli was the first man to get there. Inside. Pretty good, two big thumpers in there. And Ceramelli, a fullback, and he gets it, and he hammers the left side of the line, and I don't think he made it.
Maybe second effort got it.
Might have. Number 10. Moore coming in and pick him up. Passes away. Not going to get it back. Oh, my goodness. On the third and nine. Thompson slips a little bit when he throws it. Shockey Fields is down there. The ball is intercepted by Ahmed Plummer. He got this one, but he didn't get it on his feet, going the other way.
Oh, they need to be clean.
Supposed to be a football player for crying out loud. You can't go through the game without getting the britches dirty.
Jermaine's pass is away. He's got Miller wide open. He was hit as he threw it, but he got the ball there. And Miller
with Joe Montgomery.
And nailed back, and Joe's got it. Keeps on pounding away. First contact.
Got it again.
Down to the two.
Yep.
And he's got it. Got away from Sean Lee.
Great job up in Wisconsin.
Second down, nine. Outside. Ain't nothing going on outside, folks. We got it. Back goes Kevin again. Pressure coming, and the pass is away down the sidelines, and it's just too long out of bounds.
Down from the 38.
Jermaine looking around all day and then runs out of time as Brad Scioli arrives one more time.
Which is nice to see.
Third down and four. Jermaine back, throws quickly again to Boston, and it goes through his hands. And the Nittany Lions are in be careful country.
You got
ball
that right.
Back on the 3-yard line. Thompson's going to throw it out of the end zone, gets it off, and overthrows McClue.
And this defense is aggressive.
Look out. Incomplete. It was a battle between Shoffy Fields and Ahmed Plummer. And Katzenmoore was all over
getting on his case.
Michael Wiley looking to get outside and can't do it.
Heck for taking those courses.
Jermaine's pass is incomplete. Intended for Lumpkin.
He doesn't have that ability to think of himself as a second-string quarterback.
Fumble that snap. Center and had to cover it, so on fourth and 10 they were going for it, and he never got away with the ball off the snap. Sophomore out of Hoboken, New Jersey, 6'1", 205. He's still in the seasoning process. Big arm, lets it go.
Dang, the Badgers
well, yeah,
that's tough.
Casey's about to get a taste, but they miss him, and then he pulls it down and takes off, and this is what he can do. Casey back.
He may bite you in a good way and or in a bad way.
Casey's still got clean bridges. Drop the football. Rambo is waiting. Took his time. Oh, that's a good kick. Up into the raindrop. Kenyon Rambo. Dropped
penalty by a small at the 9-yard line for Ohio State's Joe Montgomery.
Production manager Amy Hussey.
Jamar Martin is in the ball game. That big freshman quarterback, and he's got the ball. And he's out to the 30, and
here's
it's a
mother writing me a letter. He's from Tallahassee. Our computer specs.
Although this is Michael Wiley, and Michael Allman
can have for a coach. I don't know that I've ever heard anybody not Woody Hayes, whoever worked before.
This is Wiley. Look out. Oh, he got a little thing.
You didn't know what was west of the Hudson.
Ball comes sprinting up. They're going to call it down.
They do. You're exactly right.
Jermaine's pass is, he's hit just as it is thrown there.
It is fourth down, so I don't know. Joe may be through for the day.
Yeah,
we'll see about
he
that.
He gets under his right arm and hits him.
And the Lions have the ball first down at their own 9-yard line. They hand that ball inside, and there's some room for Eric McCoo.
He knows it. He turns him loose.
From the 12, Rashard Casey takes it, gets him. Rudzinski in the air. That ball's out of bounds. See ya.
He is a senior from Modesto, California. Blitz coming. They go after him.
And the ball comes
Arrington
out.
Arrington took it away.
And Arrington has the ball. Oh, that's a fierce greeting for Garcia. Arrington came boring in. And so
he's going to inch up, and he's going to time his blitz just when the ball is snapped. And he was trying to give the ball off, and he gave it to Arrington, or Arrington took it away.
I've never seen
right there.
Like that. He almost... Garcia turned around to hand it to his running back, and instead Arrington had it.
Last game of the season.
Casey, who's yet to complete a pass, finally does. Casey slipped a little bit, but gets his pass away, and it is incomplete. Ball's thrown outside to Corey Jones, and Jones had no chance. And Plummer, they're keeping him busy right now.
Garcia pitches back again, and same fella, carrying the ball, Jonathan Wells.
He's out of River,
losing to Notre Dame and to Syracuse.
Garcia rolls it out. Brendan Short's after him, and
Mr. Short has
Derek Combs is the deep back now. Fresh legs with a clean shirt
in the backfield for Ohio State. He's got the ball. Now he can go to the long. Somebody said there were Penn State writers. I didn't see any. Paramedics didn't make the trip, so I guess everybody's all right. Derek Combs carrying again.
The Chevrolet players of the game as the clock winds down. The most valuable players for Penn State. LeVar Arrington, 12 tackles, a sack, 2 forced fumbles, and a fumble recovery. For Ohio State, D. Miller, 6 catches, 108 yards. A Chevrolet donation made to each school's general scholarship fund. For these people, a Chevrolet tradition for more than a quarter of a century. And so it's final. Number one, Ohio State 28, Penn State 9. We hope you enjoyed it. Now here's a dry John Swan.